you, Dottie. And welcome to you all. And I know Thursday night we're always a little bit fewer in number, but we know that that will increase and grow as the weekend progresses. And I trust that this has been a nice opening day, a couple days and some maybe a few more, to just be able to fellowship in a little bit more relaxed atmosphere and to renew acquaintances. And so it's with pleasure we can come and gather tonight and sing praises to God, offer up our prayers to Him as well, and sit under the ministry of the Word as well. We look forward to that. So, let's start by singing. We're going to sing, "To God Be the Glory." And let's stand. Let's fill the room with our voices. Let's sing to His glory. Facing a task unfinished. It's a familiar tune. If you haven't heard the song, the tune is the church is one foundation. And an extra chorus is added to it as well. This was made sort of popular by Keith and Kristen Getty. And so hope you can pick it up quickly. And this is our mission as the church, global, and as a convention, to make the gospel known, our task that's unfinished till Christ returns. So let's sing that together.
Facing a task unfinished. Still coming, 15 to 20 of them on the road as we speak, so keep them in mind for traveling jerseys, for traveling mercies, as well for tomorrow. There's some stormy weather forecasted, so for the safety of the roads tomorrow, for those that are traveling tomorrow. Tomorrow morning, 9 a.m., ladies will meet in for a ladies missionary rally, room 301. Men will meet for fellowship hour in room 303. After short break, after those meetings at 10:30, missionary reports. We're expecting three missionary families to present at that meeting. So we will hear about the work in Nepal and two from Czech Republic. If you love the King of the Instruments, and you know what that is, you want to be at 2 o'clock across the road in Fort Chapel. Dodie will play for us that magical instrument. We are so looking forward to it. So many of us enjoy that. For children, listen up. Tomorrow, 2 to 4. Those are easy numbers to remember. 2 to 4. Pool opens. And there will be lifeguards on duty between 2 and 4. So does the sport complex. From my understanding, is a pickleball scheduled for tomorrow between 2 or 4. So if you heard about it, I never played. I was told it's a fun game. If you heard about it, want to try it, tomorrow is the time. Brother Wojciech will show you how that's played. I mentioned stormy weather tomorrow. It is in a forecast, 80%, but there's always 20%. And our Lord is good. Our Lord is faithful. We'll pray for the weather. If not, we have a plan B. We will meet in the Henderson Central atrium if the stormy weather comes. So we will make a decision around 2 o'clock in the afternoon. That's when a kitchen has to know, and that's when we will make a decision. By then we'll see the radar, and we will post the final decision on the registration desk in the North Village too. So if we are kind of in a limbo, we cannot guarantee you it will be in the gazebo. We hope and pray for it. If not, we will let you know by the sign on the registration desk, and in that case it will be in the atrium of Anderson Center. So tomorrow afternoon, picnic, Lord willing, on Saturday morning at 9 a.m., Bible studies. We have Bible studies in both Slovak and English. Again, English is in room 301, Slovak is in room 303. While we'll have Bible studies, our youth will, Lord willing, go to their own Bible study to the local state park. And Peter and Philip have to know how many of you will go so they can purchase enough food for Saturday. And they'll have to know tomorrow afternoon, by tomorrow afternoon. So please, if you're planning to go with youth to the picnic on Saturday to the state park, please let Blaschitz boys know so they can purchase enough food for everybody. Saturday after business, after Bible study, we'll have a convention business meeting. Please, if you have a chance, please attend at 10:30 on Saturday morning. And on Saturday evening at 7, evening service. And if you love to sing, and if you love music, there is an excellent service to attend. For any other information, like how, if you don't enjoy the AC running all night, feel free to come and see me. I'll tell you how to turn that off completely so it doesn't work. Wi-Fi connections, all that information is in a delegate package. Please refer to the delegate package for that information. And at this time, Miss Pickles is standing in the door and waiting for the little ones. And on your way out, make sure, is Sophia around? There she is. Okay, on your way out, you can high-five Sophia. She grew a lot in a year, didn't she?
Oh, yes.
And tomorrow, when you have a program, I think her grandma will kind of keep her around. So Sophia will always be around your program in the morning, okay? So children are dismissed. Thank you.
Just to clarify, it's Mrs. Pickles. Mrs. Pickles. Mr. Pickles is working on his master's, so hoping that he finishes that in the next few weeks. We'll take a collection at this time as well, so if there's a couple of men able to help us out with that, we'll do that now and go to prayer together. Let's pray. Father, we acknowledge that you are the one who has given us all things richly to enjoy. And you have given us these things to be good stewards of them. So may we be good stewards of what you have given us, including our financial resources. May you use the money not only from this evening, but Father, throughout the year as we collect it to further your kingdom. May it supply the needs of those who are ministers of your gospel, and may their ministry have great effect in the Czech and Slovak republics, as well as many other places. So, Father, use these gifts, Father, to your glory and for your kingdom purposes. In Christ's name, amen.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dottie. Open my eyes that I may see. We need God's Spirit to illumine us, to understand His Word, and look forward to hearing from our special speaker this evening. But before he comes, before Darko introduces him, let's sing one more hymn. I love to tell the story, and it may not be the truth of our hearts that we do love to tell the story of God's grace to us. We'll stand together and sing. Here. Is Darko in the building?
Do you want me to get him?
That's okay. I'll introduce the speaker. I had an opportunity to speak to our speaker tonight, Darko Kralik, and his wife with us here from Slovakia. And I didn't get all the details I would have liked, but they have been in Slovakia for 23 years. Born in Serbia, married in Serbia, correct? They have two children. One is finished university, finished a theology degree. The other is in university, a pharmacist. And so they were here with us at our 100th anniversary in Philippi, West Virginia. And that was their first time here. And And now they are with us again. Adarko, remind me now, currently or was president of the Slovak Baptist Union, or currently president?
It's complicated.
I saw that. You can explain it to us, okay? And but has been serving, has served as president of the Slovak Baptist Union, obviously one of the unions that we support as a convention. And so I want to invite you up this morning, this evening, brother, to bring the word of God to us, and may he use you tonight for our hearts' purposes. Come on. Let's welcome him.
It's my privilege to be here with you again after some years. It was 8 years ago. I've been together on Czechoslovak Baptist Convention in Philippi. It's good to see you again, standing firm in faith and in one spirit, striving together as one for the faith of the gospel. Roy, I'm thankful for your invitation to participate this convention conference. And I bring you many kind regards or greetings from brothers and sisters from our churches in Slovakia. As was mentioned, I was president of Baptist Union until 1st January this year, but technically I'm still president of Baptist Union, but we are going to have another voting to another president next year, but this year is a little bit like vacuum, I don't know how to explain. But technically, I'm still president, but brother Jan Seller is vice president, and he's continued to serve in this ministry. I'm thankful that in spite of big distance, I believe we are still united in one body of Christ and in one spirit, and we have the same hope of our calling. We have the same faith in the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. In the beginning, I want to express my thankfulness for you have our churches in Slovakia, in Czech Republic, in your hearts, that you pray for us, that you support us, and that I'm thankful for support you have given to us, but not only financial, but also that you sent some missionary group last summer to some missionary team to help us in our mission effort in our churches, and really let God bless you all. It's my privilege to share a message from the Word of God this evening, a message of hope we have in Jesus Christ. The main topic of this conference is, it was there, the light of the world, light of the world. And according to John 8, chapter 12, it's definitely clear that this genuine light, the light of the world, light that brings eternal life, is our Savior Jesus Christ. Because Jesus said, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will have the light of life. That means that without Jesus, we would be people walking and living in deep darknesses. Isaiah 9:2 says. But this is not all story. Praise the Lord. God loved us so much that he gave us his beloved son, Jesus Christ, who saved us. Apostle Peter says in 1 Peter 2, 2 chapter 9 verse, that he saved us from the darkness of sin and called us out of this darkness into his wonderful light. That means that in one hand, Jesus is this light of the world. But our topic for today evening, is the light of God's Word. That means Word of God is the light. And I would like to read one verse from 2 Peter, 19 verse. This verse was given to me and to us for this convention, for this evening. Because as believers and followers of Jesus Christ, we need light for our daily life. We need some lamp for our feet. We need a light for our path, as Psalmist says in Psalm 119, verse 105. Your word is lamp for my feet and a light on my path. Also, Proverbs 6:23 says, for your command is a lamp, your teaching is a light, and your correction and instructions are the way to life. That means we see from these verses that on the one hand, Jesus is the light of the world, but we see that also his word, Jesus, or word of God, is a light that we need for our daily life. And I'm going to read from 2 Peter 1:19. This is the verse we have for today. And we read, we have the word of the prophets as something completely reliable, and you will do well to pay attention to it as to a light shining in dark place. Maybe you have another translation, but I mean the meaning is same. This verse from 2 Peter 1:19, work now? PowerPoint?
Yeah, it's just so it's not in your
face. Thanks. I prepared some PowerPoint presentation to easy follow, but something was wrong before. Okay, that according to this verse from 2 Peter, 1st chapter 19, we also see that this light that we need in our daily life as followers of Jesus Christ, the Word of God. And but question is, why is the Word of God the light we need to not go astray on the road of life? Why we need that light? Why Peter said that we should pay attention to it as a light shining in the dark places in our life? And keep these questions in your mind, because we are going to give some answers according to this verse from 2 Peter 1, 19. And I would like to share some things with you very briefly. First, because the Word of God is the one and only source of truth. Therefore, we need to keep and study and obey the Word of God and to walk in His light, because the Word of God is the one and only source of truth. And maybe you have a question, how do we know that Bible, the Word of God, is, as another translation says, more sure or more certain than anything else? How we know? How we know that Word of God is surest source of the truth? How we know that Word of God is completely reliable and sufficient and truthful? Let me tell you some things from this verse and from Bible, of course. We know because the context is Peter explains that he was together with other disciples on the Mount of Transfiguration. And we know this because of this Peter testimony in these verses, because Peter saw the revelation of Christ's glory on the Mount of Transfiguration. But Peter himself testified that God's word is more sure than the vision of Christ's glory. Word of God is more sure than the vision of Christ's glory he saw on the mountain. It's more sure than his experience he had on the mountain when he saw the Jesus Christ, his glory. But we know that his experience was glorious and wonderful, but Peter also knew that this experience is never to be repeated. It's never to be repeated. That means truth never can be measured by our visions, not our experiences. Therefore, God has given us something better, Peter says, something better, more sure than visions and our personal experiences. And that is the light of truth of Word of God. The second one, Peter says that Word of God is given by, is prophetical or is given by many or written by many prophets, and that means that we know that Old Testament prophecies, also New Testament prophecies, have come true. Therefore, we know that the Word of God is one and only source of truth, because Old Testament prophecies, New Testament prophecies have come true. And Peter says that Word of God is the word of prophets. And we know that hundreds and hundreds Old Testament, New Testament prophecies have been literally fulfilled. We do not have time to count all of that, all of those prophets were, but as Jesus said in John 17:17, when he prayed for us, he said, "Oh God, your word is truth." And it's affirmed by history that many prophecies has come true. And another thing we know, because God's word had stood to test of time. Because the Peter said in this, and that we have the prophetic word more fully confirmed. Word of God stood the test of time. We know from history that the Bible has been ridiculed, rejected, banned, burned, and maybe many people try to stop that light of Word of God. Even church leaders in history tried to stop that light of Word of God. But we know that, as Jesus said, is as never and will never pass away. According to Matthew 24:35, Jesus said, "Heaven and earth will pass away, but my words will never pass away." And another thing we see, how we know that the Word of God is completely reliable and sufficient and truthful and more certain than anything else in this world, because God's Word has miraculous power to change our life. Miraculous power. Well, you have your own experience, a personal experience. David in Psalm 19:8 says, "The law of the Lord is perfect, converting the soul," or has power to change our lives. Or James 1:21 says, "Accept the word planted in you, which can save you or give you new life." And we know those verses from Apostle Paul, Romans 1:16, well-known verse, that the gospel is the power of God that brings salvation to everyone who believes. Salvation or new life. And the last one, why we should pay attention and why we need follow the light of the word of God, because the word of God testifies about the one who is the way, truth, and life. According to John 14:6, this is Jesus Christ. That means when the light of the truth, light of the word of God enlighten us, lead us to the Jesus. And we read in John 8 that Jesus said, "I am the light of the world." That means, and I saw that tomorrow or next day somebody will explain us more about 2 Corinthians 4:6, and we can experience a unique moment when we read word of God, when we follow it, when we obey it. We can experience the unique moment, according to 2 Corinthians 4:6, that the word of God starts to shine in our heart, in our mind, in our life, and give us the light of knowledge of God's glory displayed in the face of Christ. And the word of God says something happened in our lives. Wow, light. And we can face or see Jesus. This is the first opinion or the first truth, that Word of God is a light, is one and only source of truth. And the second one, Peter says that Word of God, and we have prophetic word more fully confirmed, to which you will do well to pay attention as to a lamp. It's written lamp or light shining in dark place in our life. That means Word of God is shining light in our lives. A New Living Translation says, "We have even greater confidence in the message proclaimed by the prophets. Pay close attention to what they wrote, for their words are like light shining in dark place." And this is very important to know, because as a follower of Jesus, as a disciple of Jesus, as Christian, We are facing many difficult situations. We are facing dark situation. Sometimes we lost our direction in our life. Sometimes we experience some dark days, maybe, or dark experiences. Therefore, we see that God's word is essential light for us in this dark world. It shines in dark places in our life. It shines for our safety, showing us where to go and where not to go. It opens up new possibilities for us, open up our eyes, and we see many maybe good way we should follow. It allows us to do things we could never do in the dark. That means it shines for our safety. It keeps us. It keeps us safe in our journey when we follow Jesus Christ. Another, we know that the light of the Word of God is able and powerful to dispel the darkness of our unsureness, insecureness, uncertainty, doubtfulness, disbeliefs. It's able to dispel our fears, our anxieties, our turmoils, and so on. This is power of the Word of God. He shines in such very difficult situation in our life. And we know that the Word of God shines for our direction. It gives us direction. When we are trying to find our way through the journey of life, God has given a spiritual compass or GPS, God positioning system, that will lead us, give us direction, and keep us on the right way. And that guide, that GPS, that light is the Bible, is God's holy word. The truth we can find in the Bible, or truth, never changes. Which is important, the Holy Bible will always point us in the same direction. There is one direction. It will always point us to Jesus. Lead us to Jesus, who is the light of the world. That means second one, the Word of God is shining light in our lives. Therefore, Peter says, and you should do well if you pay attention to it, if you keep it, if you study it, if you obey it. And third one, Word of God, Peter said, Word of God came by God's Spirit. Word of God, God came by God's Spirit. Peter says, for prophet, in the verse 21st, he said, for prophecy of the scripture never came by the will of man, but holy men of God spoke as they were moved by Holy Spirit. That means the Holy Spirit of God is the primary author of Bible. Yes, we know that God used by his grace men, but Peter says that those men were all moved by Holy Spirit. Therefore, continuity of the Bible is another amazing aspect of this book, of Bible. Bible is written, we know, over a period at least 16 centuries, by more than 40 different authors, if I'm right. And we know that they differ in language, culture, backgrounds, experiences. Among those 66 books we have in the Bible, many authors, we can find some kings, philosophers, fishermen, scholars, poets, and so on. And it is hardly expected for their writings to be in harmony. But you know that their writings of the prophets, as Peter says, is in perfect harmony. That affirms that the Bible is surely Word of God. And therefore, I would like to encourage you, encourage all of us, keep the Word of God as light. Proclaim Word of God as the blessed hope we have in Jesus Christ. We should proclaim or to share this light of Word of God, special good news, the gospel of cross we have in Jesus. Gospel, how Jesus died for us, our sins, and how he rose again from death. The news or the gospel that Jesus will save anyone who will open heart to receive Jesus as a Savior and Lord. The news that Jesus will come again in his glory, and we can see his glory very similar as Peter saw on Mountain of Transfiguration. That means this is the third thing. We should pay attention, we should follow the word of God, we should keep it and walk in His light, because the word of God came by God's Spirit. It's the word of living God. And in conclusion, it's my prayer for all of us to make the word of God the pillar and the norm of our life. To allow the word of God to be light that shines and on the path of our life to lead us. To lead us in our way, in our journey when we follow Jesus Christ. To lead us to the Jesus. To let the word of God, the living God, let it be our joy, our hope, our strength, our wisdom. Let the word of God will be the light that transforms, in the first place, transforms our lives to live for the glory of God, and through us to bring the life of salvation in Jesus to the people in our generation. And therefore, I would like to encourage all of us, keep studying the word of God, keep living in the light of the word of God. Let the word of God shine, because the word of God is the light, as Peter said. Let it shine in our lives, because this is the way how we can fulfill Jesus' command. You should be light of this world. Let God bless you and bless all of us. Amen.
Testing. There we go.
Amen.
Thank you, brother, for that challenge and message from that verse in particular, that God's word. It's one of my favorite verses, that God's word is more sure than anything even our one-time experiences can estimate, and it's our sure guide for life. So we want to close by singing a song about the surety of God's word. It is a sure foundation for our lives, for the life of the church. So stand together as we close and see how firm a foundation.
What more can he say?
course, last verse, without the piano and without my microphone, I just want to hear your voices, lift them up one final time tonight, okay?
The soul that on Jesus hath leaned for repose, I will not desert to its foes. That soul, though all hell should endeavor to shake, I'll never, no, never, no, never forsake.
That's a great singing. Before you see it, brother, would you come and close in prayer for us tonight? And you can do so in Slovak as well. I'm going to put you on the spot. Let's close.
Okay, let's pray. Pane Ježišu, chceme ďakovať za celý dnešný deň, ktorý si nás v milosti požehnal. Chceme ďakovať za Tvoju milosť, v ktorej trváme, v ktorej sme, pre Tvoju obeť na kríži. Chceme, Pane, ďakovať za toto spoločenstvo, že môžeme tu byť ako Tvoja cirkev, ktorý stojíme pred Tebou. Pane, chceme ťa chváliť, chceme vyvýšiť Tvoje sväté meno za tie mnohé roky, ktoré požehnáva, že toto spoločenstvo, túto Československú konvenciu, Pane, za bratov, za sestry, ktorí stojí v rôznych službách, Pane. Chceme ďakovať za Tvoje dielo, ktoré konáš tu v Kanade, v Amerike, alebo na Slovensku, v Česku, Pane. Prosíme, aby si nás, Pane, spolu požehnal, Pane, aby si požehnal aj toto slovo, aby naozaj Tvoje slovo mohlo byť tým, na ktorom postavíme svoj život, pretože nás vedie k Tebe, ktorý si svetlom tohoto sveta, svetlom nášho života. Tak, Pane, prosíme, aby naozaj Tvoja cirkev v našej generácii mohli sme byť tými, ktorí odzrkadľujeme Tvoje svetlo v našich životoch na Tvoju slávu, ako spáse mnohým ľuďom okolo nás. V mene Ježiša Krista, prosím.